Hey guys, what's up? It's me, the Brave Hylian, and I'd like to welcome you back to Let's Play Donkey Kong Country. Last time we finished up World 1, got all the secrets there, so now we're gonna start on World 2, Monkey Mines. What do you say? Yeah, so this is where we really start to get into the meat and potatoes of the game, some of the harder platforming levels, and we've got a level coming up here in a second that is pretty iconic in my opinion in terms of platforming levels in general. So this level is really easy. We get introduced to Winky, who is our frog buddy here. He is really good at jumping really high. He can also kill most enemies by stomping on them, most notably bees, which is pretty much my favorite quality of Winky here. And we get lots of bananas here. Yuck. I actually don't like bananas in real life, so can't quite get into the full banana collecting spirit in this game. Shit, man, that was not good. Lost Winky, but it doesn't matter. Hey, we got Kong. Is that the first time we've gotten that all game? Basically, what happens when you collect all four of those letters is that you get an extra life, which, you know, we don't really need right now, but hey, we beat the level and we got the secret, so we're moving on to Minecart Carnage, which is without a doubt one of the funnest levels in the whole game. You're introduced to the minecart concept here, which also went on to become a theme in later games. In this level, you jump with your cart, so you were gonna stay in this cart pretty much the whole time and jump over obstacles, grab nanners, and hopefully finish the level. The good thing about these levels is that they don't have any secrets in them, so you don't need to worry too much about anything other than just beating the level. So this level does have a shortcut in it, which, man, that wasn't supposed to happen. Which doesn't really count as a secret, but there's a barrel at the beginning of the level that warps you to the end of it, basically. And it doesn't count as an actual secret, so that's why I like to just play this level, because I think it's really fun. If you want, you can get that barrel and just skip it. I might show that, just to let you know that it's there. But I don't really use it too often, just because this level's fun. So they have barrels like that in a lot of different levels that just let you warp to the end. Well, not always to the end, but close to the end usually. And they're good to have sometimes. When I see a lot of speedruns being done in this game, I see people using those to sort of finish the level, and then they go back in to get the secrets, and then they can start select once they get to the secret area, so they don't have to finish the whole level. But I like to play the levels just because I feel like that's the way that the programmers intended you to play this game. And I do like going fast on this game. I do have a best time that I worked hard on to get. But especially on an LP and when I'm not trying to go fast, I like to play the levels just because the reason that I play this game is to enjoy it. So here we go with the barrel guessing game, and I didn't mean to get two of those right. Did he get so angry he stomps his hat and throws it to the ground, and it's all very immature, but I suppose he is a little monkey, so we'll forgive him for that. Get the checkpoint barrel. I'm sorry I haven't been explaining too much about this game, but I assume that most of you out there have played it. There's bananas, there's barrels. It's a pretty simple concept, but oh gosh, my controller is squeaking down there. If you can hear that, it's my joystick on my controller squeaking like crazy, and it just sounds really stupid because it just does that. Don't ask me why. So if you hear a shrill squeaking in the background, I'm sorry about that. But since I don't have an actual microphone that I'm using right now, probably isn't going to pick up too much besides my voice. I'm actually using a webcam as a microphone right now because I was using a Rock Band microphone to do videos before, but that microphone is no longer available to me, so I have to use this webcam that I don't really use for anything else. It picks up sound pretty good, but if these videos come out sounding pretty crappy, then I might just pitch them because I'm not sure how the sound is going to come out. I tried to record one other video on them before, but they Oh, excuse me. The sound came out pretty good, but can't guarantee that that'll be repeated. So, anyway, these are the stop and go barrels here, and basically you have these rock crocs is what they're called, and when it says go, they run and they kill you, and when it says stop, they kind of duck and you can just ignore them. So, it's pretty much the premise of this level. And then you have these clap traps that really annoy the heck out of you because you can't stomp on them at all. So, this level is certainly an annoyance to most people who play this game. I don't mind it so much because a lot of it is just muscle memory and knowing what is where, and that secret right there is sometimes hard to get. We'll just skip to the end here and. There is a secret up here. We need to push the tire over there. This secret actually took me a long time to find when I was first, trying to 100% this game. That one took quite a while because you're not used to so much bringing things back in the level to help you out, like the tire. A lot of the time it's more of bringing a barrel or something, bringing it forward and hanging onto it for a while to get to a secret, so. There is also, oh crap, I didn't kill that claptrap, are you kidding me? I always get really nervous when I don't have Diddy, because he's definitely the better jumper and roller, and just, he's much easier to control than Donkey. And that is total bullshit right there. Because you have a grace period when they're not trying to kill you. That's crap right there is what that is. See, because when they're kneeled down, they don't kill you, but I thought he would still be kneeled down. Apparently I did not calculate that correctly. That was some crap is what that was. What is that noise? There's like a noise outside my apartment. It's like, I don't know if it's like a, I have no idea what. Oh, it must be that there's like a drainage pipe that's right next to my door. It's really annoying because there's like water dripping down there. It's coming right through my door. That sucks. Hope you guys can't hear that though. It's not that loud, so you probably can't. But yeah, it's just really crappy outside in general. There's snow on the ground and the parking lot's all icy in my apartment complex and. Ugh, that's just nasty out there. Really glad I didn't have to go to work today, just because it's just nasty out there. It's really cold, and I did have to go out there to the mailbox to put a bill in there, but it's pretty frigid, so glad that I'm in here in the warmth playing video games for you guys. Very excited to be making videos again after a brief hiatus, you could say, of about a year and a half, so. Yep, very excited to be playing this game for you good people. I'm not sure what I can really add. This game is great. There's nothing I can really say about it, you know? I can just play the levels to the best of my ability, and this game also has a great two-player mode. It's probably one of the best out of, like, platformers that were pretty much made for single player. You can do a competition where you're you each have a Donkey and a Diddy, and then you compete to see who can do the best, and you take turns playing. Or what you can also do is like a co-op mode where you basically, one of you is Donkey and the other one is Diddy, and you play together, and whenever Diddy dies, Donkey goes, and whenever Donkey dies, Diddy goes. It's pretty interesting, but the bad thing about that is that one of you has to be Donkey Kong, obviously, so yeah, I mean, I keep talking shit about Donkey Kong. He's not that bad to use, but I just much prefer Diddy because he's just more agile. There are certain enemies that Donkey Kong only can kill. We actually saw them a couple of them earlier in this level. They're those big blue dudes that sound like they're burping when you kill them. They're like, oh! But yeah, only Donkey Kong can really kill those. And there are some other enemies that even Diddy can kill them, but it's a little bit more difficult. Winky can't make this jump right here. Maybe he can. I don't know how he would do it. So I just usually leave him here because the level's pretty much done anyway. So. Oh, we'll get the bananas. What the hey. Yay, another level done. And we move on to Cranky. Screw you, Cranky. No one cares about you. And we move on to Master Neki, who shoots his little nuts at you to try and kill you, but all you have to do is jump on his head and he will be vanquished. Yeah, the bosses in this game are pretty much laughably easy. It's, you know, jump on a tire, jump on the boss. Nothing to it, really, so. There we go, that's World 2, and I do believe we did pick up everything there was to pick up, all the secret areas, found some new animal buddies, and did it up. So that'll be all for Part 2 here of Let's Play Donkey Kong Country. I'm the Brave Hylian. Thank you so much for tuning in to watch me play, and I'll see you in Part 3. Bye now.